Welcome to Mini Bible, 15 verses, 15 minutes. We're looking at Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 15. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw the light, and it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. And God said, "Let there be firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters." And God made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven. And the evening and the morning were the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the heaven be gathered together unto one place, and let the dry land appear," and it was so. And God called the dry land earth, and the gathering together of the waters called he seas. And God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth," and it was so. And the earth brought forth grass, and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit, whose seed was in itself and after its kind, and God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the firmament of the heavens to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and for years. And let there be for lights in the firmament of the heavens to give light upon the earth," and it was so. Wow, isn't that interesting? I mean, I don't know what your vision of or your personal perspective is of creation, but when it comes to what God has said, what God has done, what God has made, what God created, wow, there's a lot of God in this. I mean, frankly, I don't know how you could get around being an atheist or being a theist if you didn't read the Bible. I guess that would be one way. But if you read the Bible, I mean, it all says God said, God created, God spoke, God called, God made. I mean, God saw. I mean, how real do you want to get? God can see. God can hear. God can create, God can make, God can do, and God can decide good from evil. And he saw that it was good. I'm fascinated by this because in reality, that's something that we forget, don't we? I mean, maybe you don't, but I do. God does, in fact, have it all under control. He has eyes that can see. He has ears that can hear. He has thoughts that he thinks. He has ability to create. He has done all these things, and we have a record of it here in Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 15. We have all of this about God and not really about creation or man. If you think about it, really, Genesis, this first part, is not about us as much as it's about him. And frankly, I kind of find that interesting because if God did all this, then I think I want to get to know him more than I want to know about how or why or where or what for that he did these things. I'm kind of like in awe when I read this to think that God, and suddenly I have this whole realization that it's God and not man. Because you know, it's easy to go man-made. I mean, we can create our own ideas of what we think about God. We can create our own ideas about what we believe about God. We can create almost everything we want to about God's or our image of God. But God created. God said. God did. God lives. I mean, my gosh, all the different descriptors that are in there about God is kind of like, oh my God. And that's really where you are. Is he your God? Is he the God of gods? Is he God the creator? Is he God who created the heavens and the earth, the night from the day, the waters of heaven, from the waters on earth, the Spirit of God dwelling within the midst of all of this going on? I mean, what do you do about God? Do you, like, just kind of ignore what's being said? Do you ignore what you've read? Do you ignore what you've heard? Do you ignore what you see? Do you ignore what you hear? Do you ignore what you know? I mean, we're told at some point in time, you know, later in the Bible, that every man has known God at some point in time, and I have to agree. I mean, if I'm just reading Genesis chapter 1, 1 through 15, I'm going, God. I mean, how many times does it say? I don't want to add it all up for you, you know, but dare I say, if you added the number of words, God is mentioned a lot. Wouldn't you want to spend your time really, I mean, kind of learning more about someone who spends all of his time right now talking about himself or being described by Moses, who probably wrote this, being that it's Genesis, and he conveys it in a oral history, because obviously the way it's written, it's not written down, by the way, in case you didn't know this. This is spoken to each other. This is oral history like the old storytellers used to tell. I mean, how beautiful does this sound? In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Da-da-da-da-da-da-dum. I mean, this is like rap. I mean, you could rap out this whole version of Genesis chapter 1, 1 through 15, and make it into rap. You could, matter of fact, make it into oral history. A Native American, an Indian, or somebody from a culture that does do oral history as opposed to writing it down, would recognize the flow of what's going on. The meter that it's being said, even when you read it, like in King James, it kind of flows, but, you know, even in other languages or other, even in the original Torah, as you read it in, you know, Bereshit, you know, it does have a flow to it, you know, it says, you know, bara, you know, I mean, there's a creation going on, there's a expression of this almighty deity that's causing these things into being. Whoa. Then we go, God. I mean, now, you know, in America, yeah, we say God damn it, or God this, or God that, or God bless you, and, you know, pretend that we're using the word God correctly. We don't believe in these guys that run around saying, well, you got to say Yud Hey Vav Hey, you know, which is the letters that represent the time when Moses spoke to God. You know, God says, hey, you know, you can't understand, and I don't have a name, so I'll give you this, you know, this is I am that I am, or I'll be what I'll be. To my people, I will be what I shall be. Well, you know, that wasn't supposed to be a name, but some people get caught up in that, you know, trying to play Elohim, or trying to play name it, claim it, shame it, fame it, you know, whatever you're going to do with the name. But really, you don't have to. God covers it. I mean, reading this, it's Genesis chapter 1, 1 through 15, and I'm looking at God said, God did, God made, God saw, God. I mean, I don't know what to tell you. I mean, you know, if you read this for the first time, without any preconceived ideas in the back of your mind, without playing with anything else, you'd have to go, God, wow. And I would have to conclude that, you know, at the beginning of this, I would have to say, oh my God, look at what God has done. And, you know, at the end of this, I'd have to say, oh my God. I'm trying to see if this will zoom in a little better. There we go. At the end of this, you know, study today in our beginning of our mini Bible series, you know, the Bible, 15 verses in 15 minutes, I'd have to sum it all up in saying, oh my God.